See that, bro. Amen. Come on, get your Bibles out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Our drummer is on vacation. Amen. We got people out on their little Labor Day, whatever day they've been doing, whatever. But, amen. But that don't stop us from doing what we're doing. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We are, want to thank those that went down to Chicago yesterday. Actually, I didn't even go. I had our team go down and you know, amen, to be a blessing down there and minister down there, amen. And that's what I told you guys was going to happen. I wasn't going to. I was going to pioneer it, get it open. But then we have other ministers and leaders that will be traveling, going down to actually minister there and help build that up. Amen. When you're building the church, it's not a one-person effort. It's a group effort. Amen. There's different gifts and talents that other people have that need to be imparted. That's why churches are so messed up, because pastors don't realize that they don't have it all. You now have other people that have gifts, talents, abilities to help edify. The Bible says edify. The Bible says there's a five-fold ministry that edifies the church. Amen. And so we send people down and amen, they'd be a blessing. Amen. I really want to, before I get into this word, don't forget about our anniversary coming up. Amen. It's going to be a big celebration because of what's going on. Amen. Amen. This is going to be a year to remember. I truly believe it. We're living in that time. So this message today is it's a teaching message. And because I had y'all standing, we're not going to be long. But this is a teaching message, and I want to get into it. It's very difficult to teach this type of message. But I'm trying to get people to understand what you're actually seeing when you're watching TV and what you're listening to in music. You need to know what it is that I'm seeing, what is happening to me, what is being transmitted to me, what is catching my agreement, what am I agreeing with. It's very important that we understand that, because we have to realize that television, if you go back and look at a man called Edward Bernays, I believe his name was Edward Bernays, I know his last name was Bernays, he was the father of advertisement, amen? And his job was to find out how the human mind worked in order to sell his psychological manipulation tactics to people who were selling products to corporations, to influence the masses to buy products that they probably wouldn't buy unless they was manipulated. And if you go back and look back in the 50s and the 40s, you will see those sexy women with cigarettes in their hand, and you try to figure out why did they. Edward Bernays knew that if you equate sex, sex sells. So if you can make something look sexy or make it look glamorous, remember those old black and white movies, the starlet, she always had a cigarette in her mouth, and it looked cool and pretty. And so they knew through that psychological attack on the human mind that it would cause people to want to be like that, and they would go out in order to get the image that they put in your head, that you would go out and think that if I get this cigarette, then I'm going to have this same sexiness, and that's what they're selling. So it's Edward Bernays is one of the greatest manipulators of the modern era. Everything you see with advertisement, every advertisement tactic, every commercial base comes from this guy's understanding him psychologically, delving into the human mind and finding out how we can be manipulated into buying things we don't need. Now the problem is that does not just stop with advertisement. They went on into trying to figure out how they can influence you spiritually and politically. Amen. Also, how to also turn you on and to turn you off. In other words, to build you up and to dumb you down. And right now, everything that's being released upon this culture is to dumb them down or to turn them off. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And so you need to understand this, because the people that run everything that you see, all of your communications and culture, movies and TV, they are giving you one understanding, and they are slowly changing the nature of God into the God they worship. But you don't know the God they worship, because you think that everybody is worshiping usually the same God, which is even the false understanding that we all worship in the same God. So every movie that you see is pushing you towards that idea. Every talk show, every philosophy is pushing you towards the idea that all roads lead to God. Also trying to mess with the nature of God, amen? Taking away his true divinity and even his himness. Y'all get that later on. Thank you, son. I'm flowing now. Thank you. Give my son's hand. Amen. These young girls here are faithful. When all else, they remain. Amen. Appreciate them. Amen. But we have people on vacation, and I understand people got to do what they got to do. But, amen, we're here. Now, listen to me. So listen to what I'm saying, because I got a short time to teach you, but I got a lot of information to give you. Now, what I was saying was, you have to do your research and find out who runs everything, who actually runs your media. Now, so you need to understand the media. The media is not your friend. It's not even entertainment. The media is a psychological warfare operation by the military industrialist complex. What that means is, the people that truly run the world are people who are the military, people who want wars, and because they have a God that told them, that's commissioned them, that if they would create the chaos, that he would come out of the chaos. They have to destroy the world so he can come and put the world together. In other words, what you're witnessing is a great big false flag. In other words, we have people that are in power that are purposely destroying everything so they can bring their God to fix it. That's why the Antichrist will come and fix a broken system. The system is not breaking down, but everything you're being fed is we're overpopulated. There's not enough resources. There's shortages of food. You wonder why they're spamming when we have all of this wealth and riches and money. But the reason why is because these people, these Illuminati blood families that are actually in cahoots with Lucifer, them Rothschilds and Rockefellers, they have already made a covenant that they will take their trillions and trillions, and nobody knows how much money they actually got, but they own everything just about and run the world. And their job is to bring Lucifer. Their God is Lucifer. If you look at the Freemason manual, which the Jews, the Ashkenazi Jews, most of them, or the Kabbalist Jews, and other European Freemasons subscribe to, they tell you Albert Pike said that their God is Lucifer. Say Lucifer. So when I'm using Freemasonry, I'm using the Kabbalah interchanging, because the people that teach the Kabbalah says there would be no Freemason without the 13 rituals that's found in the Kabbalah. So you can't have Freemasonry, because Freemasonry is rooted in Kabbalism, and the Kabbalism is rooted in Talmudism, not Torah, but Talmudism. And the Talmud is the oral tradition of the Babylonian elders that came out of Babylon and started teaching the mysteries of Babylon and in place of the Torah. So these rabbi Jews that say they are following a Jehovah God, which that's even another, I ain't got time to deal with that. They are not following the Torah, the first five books of the law that we have in our Bible, which is Genesis, Exodus, you know, those books. They're actually following the Talmud, which is the oral tradition handed down from the elders when they was captive and went into Babylon and learned the pagan style of worship. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So they are not worshiping the God of the Bible. Matter of fact, if you study what they worship, now you say, what does this have to do with anything? Well, these are the people that own your media. They own your record companies. They own your Hollywood. They own your TV. They own Fox News. They own CNN. Don't get caught up in Fox and CNN. They're both the same people. They own the Republicans and they own the Democrats. Don't get caught up in these two sides are a psychological ploy or a psychological trick to give you the illusion of choice. It doesn't matter. Matter of fact, Rockefeller said, I don't care what side is what, long as we finance both sides, it don't matter what they believe or they believe. We'll win because we're going to finance them, and then we're going to go over and finance them. They always play both sides. So they got us as Americans thinking, this is why you don't, listen to me, this is why we are bamboozled every 4 to 8 years, because what they do is they take the Democrats. And then they make sure the Democrats end up with a great scandal, And then all of a sudden, people start hating this liberalism, and then they want this conservatism. Then they come with this conservative leader, and he acts like he's Christian. They did that with Bush, you know, because we were so tired of the Clinton era and the lasciviousness that we saw, that we wanted strict order. They brought in this guy who said he was a Christian. Say, man, and what did he do? Led us into war. Kill people in the name of God, had us believing and voting for us. Amen. We got so, now what did they do? They destroyed Bush in the media so bad that we did not want anything to do with conservatism. So now they brought up a liberal. Now they're destroying Obama, making him look like the Antichrist. And now we're looking for a conservative. They just keep making you go back and forth, because as long as y'all fighting, thinking that it's in a party, you will never see who's actually pulling the puppet strings. Do y'all got what I'm saying? So they give you the illusion that your vote means something when you know leaders are chosen. FDR said that, Roosevelt said that a long time ago. Leaders are chosen. They're not elected. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If it wasn't true, how could all the presidents be kin to each other? All the presidents do have the same bloodline. Now, if they really chosen, how's everybody chosen from the same bloodline? Come on, y'all. They're not chosen. Okay, now. I'm trying to give you a little bit to get you into what I'm trying to say. Now, because we, so our government, the majority of your presidents were Freemasons, and they say they were Christian. Christianity is used as a front. The reason why they use Christianity, because everybody know Christianity is benevolent. They know we serve a God of love. And if you can believe, if you can get people to believe you are a Christian, people will trust you. They will give you trust based upon what they understand Christians are supposed to be. So all of our politicians pretend to be Christians. But most of them, that's why Freemasonry is cloaked in Christianity. They use Christianity to make you think, even when they indoctrinate people into Freemasonry, they make those people on the low level think they are actually into Christianity. But it's as you move up the ranks and get in those different degrees that you begin to realize that you're making oaths and pledges and rituals and laying in caskets and all that. This stuff is to another God that you really don't get an understanding of that until you get to the 32nd or the 33rd degree, where they reveal that the God that you actually worshiping is Lucifer. What Freemasonry is the same thing Kabbalism is, the same thing witchcraft is. It is degrees of the craft. Well, what is degrees of the craft? It's the ancient mystery religions that Nimrod was operating in before the flood. It's the ancient mystery religions that Noah, that was going on in Noah's day, that God destroyed the world for, because they were actually using satanic power. Y'all heard what I'm saying? And so because there are certain powers in nature that men could circumvent God to get this power, this is the mystery religion. These are the mystery schools. This is the power that Nimrod and them had. This is the power that they was operating in Noah's day. So because man, now how do they get that power? The Bible says in Genesis 6, the fallen angels came down and showed men how to mix this and that and how to do certain rituals that will release certain power in nature. Come on, talk to me. Once they found out that power, of course they don't need God anymore, because we got power. So Satan gave them this level of power that was forbidden to operate in outside of God. Y'all got what I'm saying? So what we see in Freemasonry or witchcraft or Kabbalism, you got to get this, it's all the same, or New Age or yoga or Christian Science or Scientology, all of them are trying to achieve certain degrees and levels. If you don't know anything about witchcraft, they go on levels and levels, which really means they get more devils and devils. They think they're controlling the spirits, but actually the spirits are controlling them. So this is what happens in Freemasonry. This is also what happens in most video games. I'm trying to show y'all. The craft, this mystery school, occult, that's the word, occult religion is being taught in everything. It's being taught in all forms of culture. Everything that got to do with our modern culture is leading you into the craft. Every movie leads you into the craft. That's what the goal is. It's not entertainment. Those award shows are leading you into the craft. They are doing rituals to take you into certain levels of darkness and witchcraft. Without your knowledge, because you don't have to have knowledge to even be a witch. Oh, yeah. I don't have time to get into that. But I'm trying to show you all that you are, that you can make covenants with Satan and not know you've made a covenant. You be swearing oaths and not know you swearing oaths, because the Bible says a man is entrapped by the words of his mouth. So while you singing this ungodly song that you really don't know the whole meaning to, but yet you're chanting it, you're making an oath, even though you don't know that it's an oath. All Satan got to get you to do is repeat it. That's the reason why it don't matter if you sign a contract with Satan that you understood you selling your soul. He don't care if you don't understand it. The fact is you did it. Come on, talk to me. I want to help y'all. So when you listening to these songs and you don't really know what it is they singing about, and you just repeating it, got your kids repeat, you don't know what that is. You don't know the oaths that they're making to Baphomet every time they do the nay-nay dance. The Baphomet is the nay-nay dance. They don't know every time they got the one hand up and down and they backing it up. They backing it up like in a sitting position, because Baphomet is in a sitting position, and that's why they got to get down like that. That's what they making an oath. They making a... It's a ritual. And that's why the boys, that's why when they do it, they take on the spirit of the Baphomet, which is a female and a male. Come on. That's why when you cannot see those boys doing it, and they don't look sweet when they doing it, because the spirit behind it is a... I'm teaching y'all better than y'all saying something. That's why when you think it's cute, remember that your child is inviting. It don't matter that they don't know what they're doing. The spirits are watching and say, oh, they covenant it. They calling us. Because in order for spirits to come, even witches know that you have to do a ritual to bring or to invoke, better word. So because we think entertainment is entertainment, and we don't know that our entertainment is being ran by witches, that everything they're putting out is initiating us into the craft without our knowledge, oh boy, then we can't see the end result of what all of this, of why our society is going the way it's going. But you'll see it clearly after I teach you this. Now, put my thing up there. I gave you enough. The title of this is called Shekinah Rising. It's very important you know this word, Shekinah. Many times we thought this word was actually a Christian word that stood for the glory or the presence of God. This Shekinah is a Hebrew word, but it's really used more by Jews, by these Ashkenazi Jews, not the real Jews. I told you in Revelation, the Bible says there's a people who call themselves Jews that are not. They are false, they are imposters. DNA is proven they are not the true people of the Bible. Those white European Hungarian people over in the land of Israel are not the true. Now, I've said that so many times that I'm not going to sidetrack my message by proving that. Just look at your Bible, Revelation chapter 2, and also look it up online, and you'll find out that they are not the people. They are even saying they're not the people, okay? Because time is running out, God is revealing all of this truth now. Now we're understanding they're not the people. Now, the reason why you need to know that word Shekinah is because this is the true belief of the Talmudic Jews or the modern Jew. The modern Jew hates the Torah and Christianity. They hate Christ with venom. But you must understand that if I was a politician, or if I owned Hollywood, or if I owned music, then what I would do, you would be getting my philosophy, because I would make sure that what I believe is what people are singing about and what people are having in movies. I would make sure that you would get what I wanted. You got what I'm saying? There is no way for you to not receive my spirit if I own this. So when you're watching the news, you're getting the spirit of the person that owned the media. You think the media is owned by a lot of people. No, it's owned by one people. One people, six people own about all of our media, all of our Hollywood, all of your record companies, just about, are owned by six people. And they just happen to all be these Ashkenazi Kabbalist Jews. You got to hear what I'm telling you to get what I'm saying, because you won't understand what you're witnessing if you don't get what I'm saying. Because if they are the ones that are on your media, then they are the ones that are pushing the culture, which means nothing gets on your TV or even in your radio without them wanting it there. So whatever you're watching on TV, every show, every movie, if you think about it, there's a theme in every show and every movie. It is mainly rebellion, anarchy, sex, all this sex stuff. You wonder, where is it coming from? Well, there is a certain people that have a philosophy, that are pushing a philosophy on you and indoctrinating you into their religion without you knowing it. Now, they got to get you in their religion because their God is not the God of the Bible, but their God is the light bearer or Lucifer. And they are creating a world that Lucifer can come and his name will already be in the people. Are you hearing what I'm saying? This is the reason why we see that the increase of wickedness and the normalization of wickedness, because we have been conditioned by the media to accept certain things. There, as a matter of fact, did you know the main reason that they put false flags on TV and that they cut people's heads off and they show you that? You know why they do that? It's because the more you see violence, the more desensitized you become to it. The reason why the media, the news, every night, the first thing the news do is hit you with all of this violence and violence and violence, and to the point that it becomes so you become so desensitized to violence that violence becomes normal. That now you need something outrageous to even get upset to pique your interest, because you are so used to so much crazy violence. Now, why is that? Because they have a belief, these people that run the world, believe that their God is coming out of chaos. So they have to be the ones to create the chaos through wars and violence. Violence was the reason that God destroyed the world in the days of Noah. They are creating the same violence where men will kill one another and spill blood. The more men spill blood, they are filling up a cup of iniquity. When they fill up the cup of iniquity, God will judge the earth. So that's why you see everything in movies and media is violence. Everything in music is sex. Everything in hip hop is sex and violence. Now you say, why is that? Because these people who are Kabbalists, Jews, and Freemasons, just so happen that MTV, the building is in a Masonic temple. You know the headquarters of MTV? It's in a Masonic temple. Did you know that before MTV bought that building, it was a Masonic temple, but they didn't have the words Masonic temple on it until they bought it and they put Masonic temple on it to show you that MTV was really didn't mean music television. It meant Masonic television. And that's why every award show you see Masonic rituals. Why? They are indoctrinating you into the craft without your knowledge. So when their God come, you will be full of that God. You will be full of his spirit. Y'all not catching what I'm trying to say? Oh, come on. You'll be full of, that's why they're trying to, why are they normalizing homosexuality? Because they got a God coming that's neither or. They got a God coming that's going to be ambiguous. He's going to be both. So that's why we got to understand this word Shekinah. Because they get ready to change God from a man to a woman, and you need to see it's coming. And so I got to show you this. And that's why you see everything in Christendom is all about effeminacy. Effeminacy. Effeminacy with the men, but domination with the women. So you see our females aggressive and strong, and our males are weak. Our females' hair is getting shorter, they real hair. And the males' hair is getting longer. And the Bible says, you know that it's a curse. It's just shameful for a man to even have long hair. So our women are being masculinized. I didn't want to say that. And our men are being effeminized. Why? It goes with the God. We gotta get you into the spirit of the God that's coming. The light bringer that's gonna set you free with this knowledge. Knowledge of what? Who you are. Who are you? You are not what you were created to be. So his job is to take you from the image of God, which you were created in his image, into the image of Satan. The image of Satan is a mixed up creature. That's why Hollywood worships the Baphomet. I'm going to get there. I'll get there. Put me back up there. You got to get y'all to realize this word here. And we have Shekinah Glory Ministries. We thought that was a good word. Let me give you some etymology. Shekinah, now in a Jewish and Christian theology, it means the glory of the divine presence, conventionally represented as light or interpreted symbolically in Kabbalism as a divine feminine aspect. All right, bring it down. What that means is the Jews, the Kabbalist Jews that run the world, believe that Shekinah is the female side of God. So they're telling you that God has two natures. He's a male and he's also a female. This is the reason why all other religions have a counterpart of worshiping a female. They may have a male, but they also have a female. You don't know no religions that don't have a female or a male. Or either they have a female only. The reason why is because this is the paganism or the ancient mystery religions that Nimrod was operating in, which started from Nimrod, which was the worship of Semiramis, his wife, as the goddess, and him as God, and the sun, and Tamar as the sun, which made up the unholy Trinity. So every religion has that dynamic, because they're all of Satan. They all worship in the same Satan. It's just Satan has packaged himself in different names, but it don't matter. They worship the same thing. Now, because we have a society that's really never understood religion, that's truly never understood the Bible. That's why the Bible is not taught from a historical standpoint. The Bible is taught from an allegory standpoint. It's taught allegory is actually good, but not historical. It's not taught in a factual way. It's taught as the moral of the story. So when you teach the Bible as just the moral of the story, then you look at these true things as stories to apply to your life, to get some type of hidden wisdom out of the stories in the Bible. Instead of understanding, we're talking about historical stuff. These things actually happen. Now, when you find out historical, you stop looking over all them names and genealogy and start saying, what's this name mean? And you start going and you find out what they're talking about. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Now this word Shekinah, it crept into Christianity through a movement that started right around the time we saw the great move of televangelism. What these Judaizers or these Kabbalist Jews did, because they understand that they would not exist if the Christians were not on their side, because they know that Christianity has always been a persecutor of them false Jews. All of our church fathers persecuted them. Martin Luther, Josephus, Origen, all of them persecute, but they told the truth about the evilness of these people that are really Khazar people, and they are actually what you call the serpent people. These are the people that are called the seed of the serpent. Now, I know it's hard for y'all to believe that, but you got to open what I'm, you got to get your mind free so you can understand. Because if I own media and I really was godly, then why are you seeing what you're seeing on TV? If I have a choice, you do know you can't get a record deal. Nothing will come off of a record if these people don't agree with the content. So what are you hearing coming through the music? As a matter of fact, Tel Aviv in Israel is the number one gay city in the world. Tel Aviv, it used to be San Francisco, but a poll amongst homosexuals, they took the poll and said Tel Aviv in Israel, the city of God, is the number one homosexual city in the world. Because these are not God's people. These are Kazar people. Now, y'all got what I'm saying? I'm trying to help you. Can y'all handle any more information? I want you to see this because everything, the books your children read in school, are their philosophy, comes from their philosophy. This is why they are the behind psychology. Sigmund Freud. These were Jewish people. These Khazarian Jews that are behind psychology. They came up with all of these disorders to explain away demonic possession. So instead of them saying what Jesus said, the Bible says that when the spirit came on the boy, he convulsed and fell in the fire and fell in the water. And Jesus said, it's the spirit in the boy. Well, they said he got schizophrenic. Why did they do that? Because they hate Christ so much. They had to explain away demon possession. Because when you start talking about demonic possession, then you see that God is real just based on the demonic possession. Then you know there's another world there. What their goal was to make you think, what no other world there? So guess why? So Darwin was the nephew, I believe, of Karl Marx. Wow. Just happened to be Jew. We're talking about the Jews now. They are the one that came up with this evolution theory to do what? To explain away in the beginning. God said. So they, why? Because the goal was, this is not a new thing. Hundreds and hundreds of years ago, these people got together and know the God that they are bringing here. They know the God, so they have to create the world for it. So the New World Order is them bringing, is creating a world that Lucifer will come and take over. That's what you're seeing all over the world. This is what you see. America is the headquarters of the New World Order. It's the headquarters. Y'all got what I'm saying? So if I would go back and talk about Rothschild, and I ain't got time to get into that, but Rothschild is the greatest banking family in the world. They say they own all the money. They say these people got trillions of dollars. They say nobody's ever found out how much money they got. They own our money. They own our bank. They own your Federal Reserve. These are the riches. These are the people. Well, they are these are the people that I'm talking about that believe in this Kabbalism. Y'all got what I'm saying? And so they own all the money, and that's why you see them owning everything, like all the media, because they understand that the media is how you influence the minds of people. You got what I'm saying? So this is the reason why you see a lot of positiveness, people that are positive. You know positive folk? Those people don't have an avenue to release their positivity because the media is owned by, you ever thought, why don't radio stations play positive music? You know positive music. You've heard it before. Why don't they play it? Why? You ever thought about that? You ever thought about why don't secular stations play Christian music? You ever thought about that? You ever thought about why they don't accept Christians unless we make songs with their artists? You see what I'm saying? The reason why is because these things are owned by people who do not believe in Christ. But have, as a matter of fact, they believe in their Talmud, and this is the why the Jews don't want you to ever know, and no one, a Christian, to ever read the Talmud, because the Talmud proves what they truly believe. Then what they really believe. Now you got to realize, why are you talking about them? Because they own everything. You got to understand. Please hear me. When you look at Hollywood, every movie you see, they are. Look at the credits. Look at the credits. You see Livingston, Stein, you see Levine, you see all of this stuff is them. Everything, you Weinstein, is them. When you see the credits roll on a movie, look at the credits. When you see all these names, you won't see it in the actors, but you see it in the behind the scenes, the executives. These are people that make the decision on what you see. The actors are whores. They pimp them. They prostitute themselves. That's why they got to do sexual favors to get those parts. They whores. Don't even your rappers, they whores too. They whores too. They gotta prostitute themselves. They nothing. They use them to make you think they something, but they are just nothing. They are worse than you. They are less than you. Because at least you got the dignity of your life. They don't even have that. They are literal puppets. Because it is a known fact. These chicks in Hollywood that get parts, they tell you what they have to do in the casting room. They tell you that they have to do things, favors. It's called the casting couch. And on the casting couch, you have to, the director, the producer, you got to get down with them in order to get the part. That's how they get in the parts. That's prostitution. But they whores. So never believe these actors that come out talking about they Christian. They whores. Amen. if they wasn't whole. You can't be in the industry, that industry, without, because the God of that industry is Baphomet. You got to pledge your allegiance to that God in order to be. And the main stars you see are the ones that have totally sold out to that God. That's why you only see certain people get movies. Don't y'all see that? You see Morgan Freeman, Tom Cruise. You see the main people, Ben Affleck. Why you only see the same people? Because they are the ones that have sold out. They are the elite that have sold out to the Baphomet. In other words, they have a covenant with Satan, and his job is to keep them famous as long as they live. It's going to cost them their soul and their children. And they've already decided they made that covenant. Some of them are deceived to do it, but once you're in it, you're in it. Are you there? That's why they go crazy, because they realize what they've done after they've done it. Okay, I don't want to get too much into that, because I want to show y'all. I've got to get y'all this, give y'all this understanding. Y'all there? So all of your entertainers, they whores. Jay-Z, Beyonce, whores. All of them. Our only thing in the industry is whores and witches. That's the only thing can be allowed in the industry, whores and witches. You have to be an initiated witch to even get a record deal. The contract is an initiation. It is a contract. They take that contract into seance rooms and actually put blood on your contract. So they're not signing just a contract. They're signing their life. It's a soul contract. Are y'all there? That's the reason why your artists, if you notice, they come out and they're normal and they're wonderful and they got a good spirit about them. The second album, they word. The second album, what's wrong with them? Why are they so crazy now? Because the industry, when they sign that contract, what do you do? They initiated into witchcraft. Well, initiating the witchcraft means the acceptance of spirits. So they just made a covenant with Satan that whatever spirit Satan wants to handle them, then that spirit comes and possesses them, and all of a sudden, they're no longer the same sweet person that you knew. Now they got this eccentric way. Sunglasses on in the nighttime in the house. All of a sudden they got to get tattoos over her and just change their appearance, person themselves. Why are they doing all? Why they got to tap their body up? Because that spirit now is transforming them into another image. And Satan is marked up. His false form is transferred as angel of light, but his true form is a hideous creature. See, demons don't like to look at themselves because they're hideous. When they fell from grace, those fallen angels, they became hideous creatures. As a matter of fact, one thing that word, that messed up movie Noah got right, that y'all never caught it, if you saw this new movie Noah, was those fallen angels, when they fell, they turned into these rock creatures. But that's what happened. They weren't rock creatures, but they turned into hideous creatures because Lucifer was so pretty that that's what caused him to be prideful. And God took that away from him and made him the ugliest of creation. And so demons are so ugly that they don't even like looking at themselves. That's why they change their form to you and come off as beautiful beings, but they're hideous. The reason why they hate you is because you're still in the image of God, which means you are in the image, means the glory of God, which I'm going to get into that. And they look at themselves and remember that they had the image of God at one time. Now they are hideous creatures that can never get back to that way. And so they hate God. So they can't get him. So they war with his creation. And in order to hurt God, they change his creation into their image. This is too. Are y'all there? So that when God looks down to see his creation, they look like Lucifer. They look like Satan. They walking around with these hideous demonic things on their body, even though that's what it looks like in the natural. It looks like a tattoo, but spiritually it's something there. Spiritually it's something there. It's in the spirit. It's some type of hideous look in the spirit. People don't know that in the spirit they might have a claw hand. This is deep. I ain't got time to get into that. You got to understand this. I ain't got time. I'll mess y'all up. I'll be done going too far into that. I want to stay with this. I'll teach on it one day. Listen to me. So Satan knows that in order to create the image, his image, he has to attack the nature of God. Amen. Go over to Genesis 1 real quick. Lord, it's late. Let me have him get this in. And remember, we're talking about this word Shekinah. You got to get this, because the philosophy of the people that run the world are Luciferians, which is just Freemasons and Kabbalist people, but they run the world, right? So that means you're getting their idea, they're changing the world into their world. That's what new world order mean. It means the old way, which was the way that God created the world, we're changing it into our own creation. That's why you're hearing transhumanism and transgender and trans everything. What are they doing? They changing it from what God created into, that's why a homosexual is one of the, homosexual is the image of Satan. You don't know that, but that's the image of Satan. Once they become homosexual, they no longer look like God anymore. You lose your image. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Why? Satan's a mixed creature. You're going to find, I'll show you. Look at this. Now, put me up there, Tim. Hold on. Let me get ahead of myself. All right. Come on, let me teach you something heavy. Put that up there, bro. Genesis 1:27. So God created man. Listen, this is very important. You catch this. We read over this. We skip over it because feminism has made us skip over these verses and only look at when it say man, you always put women in man. It's, look at this closely, more closer. Genesis 1:27. So God created man in his own image. Man, the male man. Let it sink in. I know y'all don't want to get that. This American feminism is terrible. It's made us, it's changing the image of God. Because you're starting to hate. What? Okay, put them in here. What is every movie show making you hate? Men. Every movie makes you hate the father. Every movie makes you look like the woman is trapped in a bad relationship. Every movie, he's a dirty dog. It's making you hate the male because the male was created in the image. God is a male. Y'all, that's why witches teach God is a female. Come on, put me back up there. Let's look at it closely because I don't want y'all to skip over. You know, we skip over scriptures because we don't want to see stuff. So God created man in his image, own image. In the image of God created he, him. He created he, him. In the image of God. Man is the image of God. Y'all got that? That's why men are getting a raw deal everywhere now. Because Satan hates the image. That's why he's turning your sons into homosexuals because he hates the image. Men are the image of God. Oh, that's why everything is targeting your males, turning them into the image. Y'all there? Male and female, now we created he, them. Y'all got that? Okay. Now, I want y'all to get what I'm telling y'all. Go ahead, Tim. Now, hold on. Take it down. Before I put this image up here, listen. Now, this is the image that I'm showing y'all. Have some maturity about your life, okay? And even your children should see it because they are the ones that's actually being bombarded because every video they throwing these signs up, every video they showing y'all this. And you need to know what this is, okay? So this is the true image of what Satan, I believe, looks like now. This is the image he hides because he don't want people to actually know that this is, he's lost his beauty, his glory. The Bible says Lucifer was so pretty. He was one of the most beautiful. And he lost it all and became a hideous creature. So he hates the image. Every time he sees a male, he hates the image. So his job is to turn that image from the male and mix it up so that it no longer looks like the image of God. That's why homosexuality truly is after men. Lesbians just following. Homosexuals, the men are who they after. Are y'all there? Okay, come on. Now, this is the image of the Baphomet. This is the image over all the music, Hollywood, and all that. This is what they worship. And you're seeing it more and more everywhere you go in videos. They even got shirts now with it on there. Baphomet is the true spirit behind homosexuality. The true spirit behind homosexuality is to turn people into the image of Satan, a hermaphrodite, mixed up creature. Thus, the epitome of confusion. That's why when you saw Bruce Jenner, the world worshiped him. The world worshiped him. They gave this guy one of the greatest. Why? Because when he stood on that stage, he was standing in the direct image of Satan. That's why do you think the world gave him so much applause? Why do you think the media came out? The media just, he's a hero. They worshiped him. Why? Because he's standing there as the image, in the image of Satan. Y'all heard what I'm saying? This is why they are trying to make your, first of all, make your children genderless. Because they are making them over into the image of Satan. So if homosexuality was just two men that like butt, then I could get with that. That's your thing. Go have your duty and leave me alone. I don't care about that. But that's not really what it's about. It's about changing the image. You heard what I'm, come on. It's about changing the image. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? If it was about love, go love. Because you know what? If y'all do all do that, y'all be extinct in about 20 years. So just go and have y'all way. But notice that they don't want to be amongst themselves. They have to make disciples. So they are over your school system. They are over your music and your school and your Hollywood to do what? To disciple your children. To make the image in your children so they can have disciples growing up. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So it's not about love and people won't get married. It's about losing the image of God. Can we keep going? Can we keep going? Come on, Tim. 1 Corinthians, go there. Come on. Turn to your Bible so you can find that out where it's at. 1 Corinthians, I know it's there, but you go find it out. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, chapter 11. I want to show y'all this. Remember that word Shekinah. I keep telling y'all, right? Keep that in the back of your mind because Shekinah is what you're seeing now. Shekinah is what you're seeing everywhere. What does that mean? Especially in church. What are you seeing? You're seeing the female representation. Are y'all hearing me? You're seeing the female representation of what they say God is now. That's why you see more female pastors. Females running the ministries. What are they doing? They are showing you the female representation. And where are the males? In the street. They done with God. Are y'all there? Can y'all handle this? 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 7, it says, for indeed, now this is the crux of what I'm saying. This is the whole point that I'm making here. If you miss this, you'll miss what I'm trying to say. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, for a man indeed ought not to cover his head, for as much as he is the image and glory of God. The man is the image. Come on. Glory is expression. He looked like God. Also, he acts like God. Image expression of God. Y'all got that? Put me up there, Tim. But the woman is the glory of the man. The woman is the glory of the man, is the expression of the man. Y'all there? Y'all got that? So glory means worshipful praise, honor, thanksgiving, great beauty, splendor, magnificence. Which means that if you want to see the greatness of me, then you'll look at my wife. Because the way she looks shows you who I am, right? Now y'all got that part, right? But if you want to look at God, then you look at the man. Because the man is the expression of God. I didn't say the man is God. Now, don't get that twisted. You know, he's the expression of God. Because, you know, feminists get mad when you start. Because, you know, most of y'all Christian women are feminists anyway. Y'all be lying. And that's why it's hard to keep marriages together. Because we got people who don't have who are not feminine. See, we have people that are, I'm going after God. You going, well, that ain't what the Bible said. Females, go out, I'm going, God. No. The Bible said that what you're supposed to be doing is walking in the glory of your man. Well, he ain't God. That's not what the Bible said. Now, if you go back and see why the Bible says Sarah called Abraham Lord, because she's talking about you are in the image of God. Didn't say he's God. So because we don't like that, then what do? We change the image. So our females don't even like the maleness in their sons. So they agree with the effeminacy. They let them grow their hair out, wear their hair long, and they let them walk around in little frilly clothes, and they buy them colors that are not fit for boys. And, you know, they do that because they really, because if a woman, be honest, she don't like the maleness. Because you have 60 years of training you to hate males. Don't lie. All I got to do is bring up the color purple. Every movie is based on the color purple. And what is the color purple? It's the male. He was the terriblest person in the world. The male was. Never mind that Suge was a lesbian. Turned the girl out in lesbianism, but for some reason nobody caught that. But the worst person was this guy that gave the woman a home and took her from her raping daddy. Nobody caught that. Nobody seen that. You know, fed her good. He put some hands on her, but that was common. But Suge came in and had sex with the girl and turned into a lesbian. Nobody see nothing wrong with that. Are y'all seeing what I'm saying? And so every movie is training you to hate men. Why? Because men are the image. Put me up right. Let me show you. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. The man is not of the woman. The woman of the man. See, you females have been exalted to goddess status. And y'all think because y'all have babies, that makes y'all leaders. But y'all bodies, what the Bible says, is not your own. It belongs to the man. When you have babies, you have babies for the man. You don't have babies for yourself, but y'all think because y'all bringing forth life that makes y'all leaders. But if you notice, all y'all can do is bring forth life, but y'all don't raise life. Because look at what y'all raising is doing. You do know y'all raising these children. Look at how they live. We got more thugs and whores now. Why? Because the women are raising them. Because you thinking because you can have them that you can raise them. But no, the father is the one that raises them. The father is the one that guides and directs. You just have them. You are the incubator. You are the machine that has the baby. But you can't even have it without the seed. That's why I don't understand how these lesbians say they want to be lesbians, but they keep getting pregnant. Did y'all get pregnant by a woman? You had to go to the seed. Why? Because you of the man, which means the man got what you need. Ain't y'all ever thought that? You want to be a lesbian? Why y'all keep getting pregnant? I know why. You want the assistance. You want the woman benefits of having a baby and getting on welfare and being taken care of. That's what you want. I think we should call tech. When you see a pregnant lesbian, say, tech, this is wrong. You told me. You got on wife beaters and saggy jeans. You told me. So now you want me to respect you as a female, but you told me. We should call tech on that stuff. Come on, put me back up there. For a man is not of the woman, because the whole part of Satan is society, chaos, confusion. He comes in confusion. The world's got to be so confused and messed up too, so you will accept him. This false light coming, which is means Shekinah. The light on the G in Freemasons. You ever seen the G in Freemasons? The light around it, it's called Shekinah. Take out your dollar bill on the side with the eagle, with the stars that shining above the stars. It's called Shekinah. It's the false light of Lucifer. One side of your dollar is talking about Osiris or Lucifer, the human side, or the male side. The other side, the female, the phoenix side, is talking about the female side. If you put them both together, you have the Kabbalah. DNA mixed up. You have Baphomet. It's on the back of your dollar. It's in the cultic writing. So the glory or the light, what is Lucifer's name? The light bearer. So the glory that's coming, the light that we, this illumination. What is the true illumination that they're telling you now what is illumination? Do you know what the Kabbalists teach? Do you know what you think? You know what they're teaching illumination is? Sexual freedom. That's light. Sexual freedom. Now to me, illumination would be what's on Jupiter? What's on Mars? What is the universe made out of? You know, that's knowledge. But notice we being dumbed down on everything else. But the only thing we are excelling in, or that's okay to explore and excel in, is sexuality. Why? Because when Lucifer, this God, comes, their God, he's going to teach the doctrine that true illumination is the essence of the Kabbalah. And if you know what the Kabbalah is, these Hollywood Jews, all these people with these red things on, it's about sex magic. What the Kabbalah really stands for is to is first you have to go do all the evil you can do, and when you go all the way down in evil, then you rise up. But you got to go all the way through the evil first. So you get there in the Kabbalah through sex. So that's why Aleister Crowley, which is one of the great Satanists, was just having to be a Kabbalist Jew. That's why he has sex with babies. Because in order to be enlightened, you got to experience sex in all its forms. That's what it's all. Why do you think everything is about sex? So that's why you see now they don't stop at two men having sex. Now we need to get the bestiality going. Then we got the children thing. Then the Bible says in Genesis 6, they saw having sex with animals and birds and beasts. What would happen? Because that's how they worship Lucifer, or Satan. Are you there? Why? Because through all of this sex, you're going to mix up creation. That's the whole goal. You're going to mess creation up. His goal is to mess creation up. What? To mix it up into his own image. Can we talk? Is this too much? Put me back up there. I want to read that last part again. I want y'all to really, because that's a revelation here. For man is not of the woman, but woman of man. Neither was man created for woman, but woman was created for the man. So why do you think Satan has turned society backwards? Where now, listen, men are now created for women. That's not how it's supposed to be. That's why y'all get a man like y'all adding him to y'all self. Like he's just something to get. He's like the accessory that I need. When a man is the main thing. Come on. Y'all been trained that a man is just something you add. So your whole life becomes doing what? Fulfilling your desire. And what does that usually lead you into? What? Sexual lust. It leads you into sexual lust. Why? Because the man is the protector of the body. See, if you would got married when you were supposed to, that man would have protected your body. So you wouldn't have so many demons in you now of lust, because you don't let so many people get inside and mess you up. And that's why your mind is schizophrenic, because you got too many other spirits in you and too many other men, mind thoughts in you, because that man's semen went into your DNA. Now that man's imprint is on your DNA. If you go deep enough to go down into the finite of your DNA, that man's, you know, DNA is marked by markers. That man's markers in you. In other words, you got other men's on your DNA. That's why you so worried. Because you have men's DNA markers. This is scientific. Now, let's not be spiritual now. Scientific. That's why you so messed up. Because you got too many other men's essence or nature in you when you was only supposed to have one man. That's why it's hard to be with your one man. That's why they're arguing, bro. They're arguing because too many men there. It was supposed to be one man there. And if one man was the one that popped the thing and did the right thing and his own one was there, then you would only have his essence and you would only have his spirit. It's not so with men. Men don't receive. It ain't like that with men. That's why the Bible says a woman is for the man. Men don't receive. It don't go backwards. Men, we shoot it. We shoot. Come on now. Y'all know what I'm saying. Nothing goes in. That's why it's not right when a man starts receiving. We ain't supposed to receive. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? We supposed to give. And the women receive. And Paul said it's a mystery that somehow we become one flesh. That means not only did it wasn't no one act and we done. When we came together, my stuff went into you. And it got down into your DNA. I'm on your DNA now. Your DNA says you my rib. Well, why are you so mixed up? Because you got Negro DNA in there fighting each other. Whose woman is this? Are y'all hearing me? This is what that scripture is talking about. The woman is for the man. Men ain't supposed to receive. Men are supposed to give. The women are supposed to receive. You got that? So Satan got men receiving. The Bible says, listen, when men start receiving, what happens? Something unseemly. They receive within themselves the recompense of their reward. That what they receive and mutates and kills them. Because men ain't supposed to receive. Y'all got that? So if you think about your craziness, you will find out you started being crazy at your first sexual encounter. Especially if you was molested or raped. That's really where, because that man transferred into you. And so because you was hot, because, you know, when you get start having, you get promiscuous, y'all know, and all of a sudden you start having multiple encounters, and you know, if you notice, the more you do that, the more crazy you become. The more men you have, the more crazy you become. You think about it. I ain't got to prove no Bible. You think, that's why you're sitting there now, like, you know what? I wasn't even into that before I met him. You know who, everybody know who was the real crazy one. And because that man's code is there, this is why the Bible says you need to be born again. You need to be cleansed. That means, Lord, because if I can go deep on you, DNA is spiritual. DNA is spiritual. And that's what happens when you get, that's why when you get saved, your DNA changes. That's why you shouldn't be sinning after you're saved, because if you're sinning after you're saved, then you're writing a new code over the, you're writing a, God wrote a new code over your old code, which is called the blood of Jesus, that covered your old code. But if you start sinning after you're saved, then you're rewriting another code over that. DNA is spiritual. Y'all got what I'm saying? So when you get born again, the blood of Jesus removes them old codes. Them old mindsets. That's why your minds change. That's why you start changing when you got saved. But you usually start sinning after you're saved. Or you give back in to that spirit, and all of a sudden you rewrite that code again. Are y'all there? Come on, talk to me so I can quit. Are y'all there? So that's why when we repent, it's not just enough to say I'm sorry. We have to say, Lord, you need to regenerate me here. I got this bad code in me. Now, if you understand this, understand it as a computer, because, you know, computers are built as a body. Computers are built off the model of the body. If you understand computers, think about it in these terms. You know when you get a brand new computer, especially a Windows computer, it ain't like a Mac. Macs are saved. I'm just kidding. But Macs don't, I'm going to tell y'all what I'm saying there. You get a Windows computer, you get it, it's brand new, right? It's doing good, right? That computer will be fine. Be real fine. Unless you have unprotected use on the internet. The minute you have unprotected use, you start downloading. Those viruses go into your directory. Which means they get on the master, they on the hard drive. It starts writing code that's not supposed to be there to make your computer pop up this foolishness all the time. And you don't know why come my computer slow there, because your computer is so slow because it's writing all this other code. It's taking so much power to write all of these virus codes that the program that it was meant to run gets slowed down. Come on, talk to me. And so you won't, and so in order to get that right, you gotta do what? That ain't what I'm talking about. No, I reset. What's the name of the things you use? Well, McAfee. You need an antivirus. That's what you need. An antivirus is a program
that captures the bad cold, isolates it. It removes it or it isolates it so that the original cold can run uninterrupted. You got what I'm saying? That antivirus will work real well until you start going into places that you ain't supposed to go. The minute you get to clicking on some stuff in weird sites, because those weird sites are designed to get in your computer. When you click on those weird sites, especially them pornographic sites, then you start, all of a sudden, those sites have stronger, because you have an antivirus that has blocked all of the bad code. Though there's other things out there that say they got an antivirus, so we need something strong. We can't mess with them. We got to get them to come to us. So they get you to clicking on stuff you shouldn't click on, and then all of a sudden this comes in your computer, and this is stronger. The person who wrote this new virus, they done studied the antivirus, so they know what more to write. That's what sin will do. That's why the Bible says when the evil spirit is cast out, it goes away, but then it comes back. Find that place clean. See the antivirus is in there, and it says, well, I need 7 more spirits stronger. Then it comes back, and now you got your emails in trouble and all kinds of stuff. Your computer's crashing, you know, what's going on? But if you go back, you remember, why was I clicking on this? Why was I surfing here? Why did I go into this? Because usually you have a program that'll jump say, don't go in here. See, that's the Holy Spirit. That's his job. He ain't going to make you not click on it. He ain't going to make you live right. He's going to say, there could be viruses on this next page. Do you really want to go here? You know how you that box come up, and you really get frustrated with that, but yeah, I want to go here. Do you really want to go here? And because you focused on satisfying whatever pleasure it is you're dealing with, you go ahead and do it, and then you end up with your spirit sick. Then you come to church, and you want to figure out, why don't the word set you free no more? Why ain't you breaking through in worship no more? You used to lift your hands and feel the presence of God come in you. Now you don't feel it no more. What's wrong? You got a virus. Now, what got you free from the first virus of sin? Repentance. Repentance. But when you become a Christian, did you know you repent less? Because we get prideful that we were in church. So we stop repenting over them secret sins, so we start living with viruses. Because to truly repent, you got to do what you did when you first got saved, and that usually takes some humility. That means I got to come down into get down here and get on down, and you know. But I'm too prideful and I'm too cute and my dress is too pretty because I've learned how to dress at church that I don't get down no more. So now I just live with the virus. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? And so this is, oh, Lord, I can't even get, I got to close out. And so this is what, so you remember that Jesus, Nicodemus came to Christ, and he told, and Christ said, Nicodemus, you know, a man ain't going to see the kingdom of God unless he be born again. You're going to have to be born again. Nicodemus said, well, what do you do? Go back into your mother's womb. And Christ said, no, Nicodemus, you're being natural. He said, you must be born of the water and of the spirit. He said, Nicodemus, you have to be cleansed here. That's repentance. Repentance comes through cleansing. The spirit is the reboot. You ever seen where sometime, if you ever downloaded antivirus stuff, you download it to the computer and then they say, you must restart this. That means start over. Go back and do your first works over. Because you done messed up since you done free. But Christians never go back. What do? You go on and try to get more programs, more books, more tapes, more teaching. No, go back and start over. Go do your first works again. So you reboot. And what happens when you restart? It starts running the program, the antivirus program again. And it starts capturing all that garbage. Then what does the Bible say? Now, once we get these viruses, don't click on nothing else. Go that way and sin no more. lest something worse come upon you. This is what's happening to people. And because we are so prideful, we just live with devils. We live with demons. And we know we got them in our life, but because we don't got used to it. Can I get done? Put my scripture. I ain't done with that scripture. I'm going to finish, but I'm going to go out on this. I have some more stuff on this message that I have to give y'all maybe on Wednesday. I ain't even scratch the surface of what I'm trying to say. Look at this. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. This verse is so devastating that most, you've never heard a teaching on it. You've never heard a teaching on the authority or the power of the man. You hear the power of God, Holy Spirit, blood of Jesus, but you never heard the teaching on the authority of the man. And the reason why is because Satan understands that teaching will bring order. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So this, Shekinah, that's what I was, so Shekinah, the Jews believe, the Talmudic Jews, which is running the world, believe that the Shekinah, when they over at the wailing wall, you know the wall in Jerusalem when they going back and forth, sitting over praying, y'all know what they, that, when they over at doing that, that is a sexual act that they are doing with Shekinah. They don't believe their gods are male. They believe their gods are female. That's why when you see all of the pictures, and the Roman Catholics also believe that. That's why they have Mary. They worship in Mary. They ain't worshiping Christ. When you, so because they believe that Christ, that they're not Christ, but their God is a female, then they're using all of their media, their books, their knowledge, their wisdom, their music to turn the image of God into a female. That's why they have exalted females in our society and they have downplayed males. That's why your child support system is like it is. Gave the woman the power over the man through the law, not through nature, because nature puts the man over the woman. But in the law system, they put the woman over the man. That's why you have brothers that having babies, and even though they love their children, they give the woman an apartment and give him the jailhouse. Why? Because they gave the woman the power over him. They did it with the law. That's why when you marry a woman, you get divorced, she immediately get power over you. You need to know that, brother. That's why you need to know the woman you're marrying. Because she ain't gonna let you go on with your life. She gonna use the power given to her, called the courts, to begin to destroy you. Why? Because what they did with the court system, with child support and alimony, was really wealth transfer. It was a way to rob the man. Take from him and give it to the woman. By way, putting a female over the male and messed up the order of God. That's why you can't be with no man now, because you've been brought up to think that you're on the same level with a man. You don't know the man's over you, like the Bible put it, say man. Therefore, but you think that the man's got to be as wise or smart as you. It's not even as wise or smart as you. It's the fact of his image. The spirit world, listen, the spirit world respects his image, because if it didn't, the Bible says that's why women need a head covered, because the spirit world respects the image of the man. Understanding he is the covering of the woman. So Satan has turned it upside down and got y'all women covering us. Y'all covering us. So guess what? If you covering me, then instead of you being my glory, I'm your glory. So I like your clothes. My eyebrows are arched. Because I'm the glory. See, I'm taking on the glory of the female. Y'all see, I'm trying to help y'all here. My hair is longer than yours. The glory of the female. That's why your sons look gay, because he's walking in the glory of the female. Because he never seen the male in the house be the strength. The man wasn't standing in the correct image. It ain't the fact he's in the house. Don't never get it twisted because a man's in the house. That don't mean he being a man. That don't mean he got the correct image, because most brothers be in the house but to be disconnected from what's going on in the house. You need a man active. Being a head active man. Are y'all there? So what Satan has been crafting, listen to me now. So this Shekinah is a trick. Because what it does is you begin to accept the female in the place of the male. Because you think the female is more spiritual than the male. Is that not what you've been taught? I don't teach it, but that's what you've been taught. How can the female be more spiritual than the male when the Bible says the man was created in the image and the likeness of God? So that got me an understanding that men by nature have a natural nature of God. If it wasn't true, then why are they trying to erase men? I'm talking about all men, not Christian men, all men. Because the image of man showed, that's why when Satan hates marriage. Because when you get married, it is that direct image. It's correct. It's what God looks like. So he hates that. But if he can't mess up, get you from being married, he'll mess up your marriage by messing your roles up. And this is what feminism done. Feminism came in and uprooted the home and began to say, whoever make the money is the leader. Forgetting the fact that money has nothing to do with spiritual authority. So the women are making the money, but Satan don't respect them. So he's stealing the home. The woman's making the money, but Satan's in the house, got the kids. So our Talmudic Freemasonry society, which is what our politician system is, helped y'all by giving the woman the power to get rid of the man and make y'all the queen bee. And now that y'all are the queen bee, you see that you cannot produce anything other than dysfunction and chaos. Don't look at the ones that the sons went to the NBA. That's luck. That's a fluke. Because if you go back and look at what the sons are saying before they went to the NBA, their mamas was a mess. It's just now he can buy a house. The dysfunction in our modern homes is coming because our females are now in the place of the male. And our females have fallen in love with that position, that even though she know it's failing, that's why feminists know it's failing, they still will stay in that position because they dislike the place of power. So the men have vacated that position, and because our sons have been raised with the female in the position of the male, they don't ever see themselves in the position of the male. So they take the submissive role. So it's not just the fact you don't have a man in your house. It's the fact that you are in the place of a male. This is the Shekinah spirit. In every sitcom, every song, every movie, this Shekinah spirit, this female goddess, God. That's why all of y'all have turned overnight into these goddess-looking women with 16-inch eyelashes and all of this goddess look and all this long hair. Why? Because this is the image. Because goddesses need worship. And so women are being worshipped as goddesses instead of being the helpmeet to the man. They're shining with the false glory or the Shekinah. But what they were supposed to shine with was the glory of the man. So you're really supposed to walk in that man's light. But you shining, but it's with the false light of the Shekinah. Stand on your feet. I'm done. Y'all ain't ready for me. Y'all ain't ready. Stand on your feet. Amen. Come on, son. Now, if you really look at, now you see marriage is deeper than what you think. It wasn't just y'all getting married. It's deep. Satan has trivialized it. He made marriage just like it ain't nothing at all. Like it's just two people like each other, and we just be together for a while, then we decide to get married. That's not what marriage is. The whole understanding of marriage, why do you think you take the man's name for? To show you that these women are shining in Shekinah, they won't even take your name no more. They're going to hyphenate your name. Do you understand what hyphenation means? I'm still me. Do you understand that's what that means? So if you hyphenate your name, you did not even take my name. So that means I'm giving you all the benefits of a husband without the respect of one. Hyphenate. That's what they're doing. Marriage is not just two people like each other and get married. Marriage is a woman actually saying that I'm actually taking on who you are. That's why the Bible says wives adapt. That means transform to your husband. Because the woman is for the man. Y'all don't want to teach this right. Transform. That means it ain't about you now. You got married to. So stop saying, I can't cook and I don't know how. Transform. The whole reason, y'all don't want Christianity marriage. Y'all want this old new age stuff. The goal is to adapt. Why? Because you're adapting to this man who's walking in the image of God. And are y'all there? And for that, listen, for your adaptation, you receive the benefits of walking with a godly man. Protection, security, which is really the main two. Love, which is what women live on. That's like gasoline for a woman. And everything you're doing on your own in your Shekinah is trying to get protection, security, and love. And you can't get protection, security, and love without a God man. So you're getting it from cupcakes, and you're getting it from wine, and you're getting it from these chicks and your girlfriends and your go-out partners, because you really want the protection of what a man is providing, but you too busy in y'all Shekinah for a man to even cover you, because you already got your own covering. The Bible says the man, oh, y'all ain't hearing me. The man is your covering. So when you submit yourself, when you submit yourself, the man now becomes your protector. He gives you security and he gives you love. Now in that three chord, you are complete. You don't even know you're complete, because feminists told you you're not complete. But these feminists have went out there for 50 years and they found out that they said women are the most unhappy group now. That's why every show you watch, what are women doing? Drinking. These women are alcoholics now. Why? Because they're unhappy. Why? Because they believe the lie that I don't need no man. But they drinking because they don't have security, protection, and love. But if they would have done it God's way, then a man would have covered them and given them security, protection, and love. So this Shekinah is messing y'all up. It's a false light. It's a light of remaking God into y'all female image. And until y'all break that and understand that God's way was correct, the way he set the home was right. And some of y'all know if y'all had the mind that y'all got now, you would have kept your man. If you understood what your role really was. But feminism taught y'all, which feminism was thought about by the Rockefellers. Y'all do know the Rockefellers came up with feminism. They paid, what's the girl, Gloria Steinem. They paid her to push feminism. They paid the papers and stuff to push feminism. You know what Gloria Steinem did? Came after y'all black women. Because she knew if I get the black women involved, the white women gonna follow them. The black women who had no issue with feminism, our men was never over y'all. We coming out of slavery, marching with afros together in the 60s. They done came with feminism, made y'all think y'all got something to fight us for. So they gave y'all welfare to kick out y'all man. Gave y'all child support system and gave y'all domestic violence laws and put us against each other. And that's why we think we always fighting one another. Child support don't bring together no family. But Gloria Steinem came and had the black women out there taking off their bras with marching as if they got something to fight for. Instead of understanding that was her and her man. The white woman was oppressed by her white man and she wanted freedom from that. But the bad thing about it, the white woman chickened out on y'all. She made y'all leave y'all man, but she still went and got married to her man. So the white woman got her man and you ain't got your man. And now she got your man. And now you're trying to catch up to get her man. Look how messed up it is. But we already had it right. You had no fight with the man. Now we all fighting. There was no fight with the man. But this Shekinah thing that made women want to shine, ain't that a good word? Oh, that's such a good word. That's a good word. That's like something in a book or something. It makes y'all want to shine without the man. Ain't that what Jezebel, unhusbanded? See, some of y'all, listen. Have you ever seen women in a good marriage, in a good home, and they still like, I just need to do something for myself. I just feel like I need my self-worth. She want to shine. She really said, I want to do something without him. I need my own glory. So she give up the glory that we got, bruh. The protected glory. The love, the strength to go out there to get around a bunch of women that eat cupcakes and drink wine. And that's all they doing. Or they go to the gym to get glory because they work their body up so they can have body glory. So they can look good for some female and some man that they cheat with to lose the glory they already had at home. Everything is about you leaving what you already got. But when you understand what your man is bringing, what you would talk to him, you wouldn't use your femininity to manipulate him, but you would use your femininity to enhance his masculinity. You would encourage him in his manness instead of trying to bring him into your female ways, trying to make him a female. You realize he ain't my girlfriend, but he's my leader. So y'all ain't ready.